To avoid this process contamination, a special device is introduced. That is called GDO. For GDO, get the drum register. First to get first with the drum and then to get first with the drum. So then to get first with the drum. That means it is a self-accommodating switch. It is a fully controlled switch. This kind of next device is GDO. Get the drum register. Get the now, register. Anode and cathode. Anode and cathode terminals. See, this is the symbol for SCR. This is for thyristor, not GTO. For GTO, the positive gate bus will turn on and negative gate bus will turn on. Positive gate bus will turn on and negative gate bus will turn on. Or we can also use this symbol. Anode, cathode, first to get pulse, negative gate pulse. Or else, we can also use this one also. Anode, cathode, and then gate. It is very simple, right? Some others are using this one also. Everything is same. So first to get pulse will turn on and next to get pulse will turn on. So GTO is a self-commutating switch. It is a self-commutating switch. GTO is a self-commutating switch. Or it is a fully controlled. Why it is fully controlled? Why it is fully controlled switch? Because the gate will decide both on and off state. That is why it is fully controlled. As self-commutating switch. Whereas in SCR, only on state. So that is why SCR was semi-controlled switch. So to turn off the GTO, first to turn on GTO, we have to give positive gate pulse. When anode is positive with respect to cathode, and then next to turn off the GTO, we have to give a negative gate pulse. So how much negative gate pulse we have to give? How much positive gate pulse is needed to turn on the GTO? What is the order of gate signal? Milliamperes, that is for SCR, thyristor. But for GTO, we need more than 1 ampere. In the case of GTO, in the case of thyristor, milliamperes is sufficient. But for GTO, we need a gate pulse more than 1 ampere, 1 to 2 amperes around. Then how much negative gate pulse we need to turn off this one? We need a negative gate pulse of 20 to 25% of maximum anode current. Suppose if the anode current is 1000 amperes, here if the anode current is 1000 amperes, then we need a negative gate pulse of 20 to 25% of maximum anode current. That means it should be 200 amperes or 250 amperes. If the anode current is 1000 amperes, then we need a negative gate pulse from 200 to 250 amperes. Then what is the structure of GTO? See, in GTO, the gate cathode is highly interdigitized gate cathode. Yesterday I said interdigitating. So GTO has highly interdigitated gate and cathode structure. That means the gate and cathode is very close to each other. Right on the point. GTO has highly interdigitated gate cathode structure. GTO has highly interdigitated get cathode structure. CGO has highly interdigitated gate cathode structure. So draw the structure of this GTO now. So this is B plus, then next L minus, then next P layer. See, alternately, gate, cathode, gate, cathode, and so on. I already said in the last class, interdigitation means, suppose this is the P layers of gates, this is the N plus of cathode, the P layers and N plus layers of gate cathode should be very close to each other. If the gate and cathode is very close, then we can increase the conduction area at the beginning itself. So this is called interdigitizing. Gate cathode alternately. Actually, here, in this case, if you see, like this, it will extend here. It will extend. It's not only this many, it keeps on extending like this. Okay. Right, and anode, this is the anode terminal. Here. So when I give first to get pulse with respect to the cathode, first anode is first to get cathode is negative, and we have to give first to get pulse with respect to the cathode. So what happens when I give first to get pulse here? So everywhere I am giving first to get pulse. This is the initial conduction area. Right? So that forms conducting area here. Okay, similarly, the gate signal is provided in this loop also. So that forms again conducting area. Similarly here also. It's called initial conduction area. When I give positive gate pulse, see, gate is injecting charge in all the dimensions. This is one dimension, this is another dimension. So this is the initial conduction area. So then anode current starts passing through this. Okay. And so on. So if you observe this one, the VA characters of thyristor and G2 are same. Understood? Only turn on characters are also same, only turn of characters will change. Write on that point. VI characters of GTO, the VI characters of GTO is similar to the conventional register. The VI characters of GTO, the VI characters of GTO is similar to the conventional register. Is similar to the conventional register. The VI characters of GTO is similar to the conventional register. Okay. So next draw the switching characters. Switching characters. Switching characters of GTO. So I already said to you the turn on characters of GTO and SCR will remain the same. Do you remember turn on characters of SCR? Delay time, rise time, spread time. So turn on characters are similar for both the devices. Only turn off characters will change. So who will initiate the turn on process and turn off process? The gate signal will initiate that one. And then we have to show how this anode current changes with respect to time. How this anode current changes with respect to time. And then how VIK changes with respect to time. So initially GTO is the off state, it is switching from off to on state. So who will initiate the turn on process? The gate signal will initiate. So this is IGM. Okay, now see here, initially GTO is in the off state. When it is in the off state, voltage across the device is maximum, right? Voltage across the device is maximum. And what is the current? And the current is minimum. Voltage is maximum, current is minimum. What did I say in the case of SCR? Do you remember? When the gate signal reaches at least 90% of final value, at that instant conduction area is developed. So this is 90% of the maximum value. That means 0.9 times of IGM. 0.9 times of IGM. Up to here. So then next what happens? When the gate signal reaches at least 90%, at this point initial conduction area is formed. In the case of GTO, initial conduction area is higher than SCR because of interdigitating gate calcium structure. The initial area of conduction is more. So therefore, the initial rate of rise of anode current can be increased in GTO, right? See, not right. For SCR, the di by dt at the beginning was very slow. So that is why delay time was more in SCR. Because in SCR, initial conduction area is very small. So di by dt is very slow, delay time is high, so turn on time is high. But in GTO, because initial conduction area is more, I can increase the di by dt. So delay time gets reduced. Understood? See, that is the difference between these two devices. So delay time gets reduced, so turn on time also reduces here. So finally, it will reach the maximum value. The maximum anode current. As the anode current starts rising, this voltage starts decreasing. this time we call it as eon. Again, I am not defining them. Up to 10% delay time, 10% to 90% rise time, remaining spread time already I have said, same logic. So at this point, G2 remains in the on state. So G2 remains in the on state, okay? And another difference is, what is this one? Tell me, what is this one? VAK during the on-state voltage drop, that is higher than SCR. This on-state voltage drop is higher than that of SCR, in the case of GTO, okay? The next, see here, another difference between SCR and GTO. See, SCR is a latching device. What is the meaning of that? When SCR reaches the latching state, SCR means conventional thyristor. If I say conventional thyristor, it is SCR. When the SCR reaches the latching state, after that even if I remove the gate bulbs, still it will maintain the continuous conduction state. It will not switch off. Similarly, GTO is also a latching device. Latching device means when it reaches the latching state, I can remove the gate bulbs even in the case of GTO. If I remove the gate bulbs, GTO will not stop conducting. GTO will maintain the conduction. Even if I remove the gate pulse at this point, in SCR also we are removing the gate pulse at this point. But in GTO, still we maintain continuous gate pulse. We reduce that one and then provide continuous gate pulse. Actually, it is not necessary. No? See, even if I remove the gate pulse in GTO, it will not stop conducting, right? See, GTO is also a latching device. Even if I remove the gate pulse, it is not going to stop conducting. But why we have to maintain gate pulse? It is not required here. Why should I maintain the gate pulse? See here. What is this magnitude? 10%. 0.1 times of 0.1 times of IEM. 10% of that final value. 10% of that final value. Okay. Why should I maintain continuous gate pulse? See, generally, sometimes there may be power fluctuations. There may be power fluctuations, right? Power will cut off just for a moment and immediately again it will on. So if the power fluctuation is there, suppose if the anode current suddenly dips to zero, and again increases immediately, what happens? There is a problem with GTO. Suppose, just like SCR, if I remove the gate pulse here, what happens? I am not maintaining the gate pulse continuously, what happens? See, I am not maintaining. See, when GTO starts connecting, see here, when GTO starts connecting, I am removing the gate pulse. When I remove the gate pulse, then who is maintaining this conducting areas? Anode current itself. See, when it reaches the latching state, even if I remove the gate pulse, why it remains in the on state? Because who is maintaining the conducting areas here? Anode current itself is maintaining the conducting area over the cathode surface. Now, due to the disturbance or due to power fluctuations, anode current dips to zero and immediately increases. The moment anode current dips to zero, what happens? When anode current dips to zero, what happens? Some of the conducting areas becomes non-conductive. Not completely, some areas becomes non-conductive. Some areas may become non-conductive. Anode current suddenly dips to zero means, what happens? Some of the areas may become non-conductive. What happens when some of the areas becomes non-conducting? Then available conducting area is lesser. Again, anode current suddenly increases once again. If anode current suddenly increases once again, the entire anode current has to pass through the small conducting area. So current density becomes very high. Current density becomes very high, very high. If current density becomes very high, hot spots will occur and device may damage. To avoid this problem, better maintain continuous gate signal, of course with reduced magnitude. You need not maintain the same magnitude. Better reduce the magnitude and maintain the continuous gate pulse. If I maintain continuous gate pulse, what I am doing? I am maintaining the conducting areas continuously. So if I maintain the continuous gate pulse, even if the anode current dips to zero and suddenly increases, now there is no problem. Because we are maintaining the conducting areas continuously by providing continuous gate pulse. So even though the anode current suddenly dips to zero, we will not experience that type of problem here. So that is why we have to maintain continuous gate pulse in GTO to maintain the conducting areas continuously. Now let me ask you one question. This will not happen in SCR. This will not happen in SCR. If it happens in SCR, in SCR also we have to maintain continuous gate pulse. Then why we are not using continuous gate pulse? This will not happen in SCR. What is the difference? See, here we are using interdigitated gate cathode structure. Wherever we are using interdigitated gate cathode structure, the conducting areas increases and decreases immediately. Understood? Because gate led destroyed. So what happens? These conducting areas becomes non-conducting immediately. In the case of thyristor, we are generally using segregated structure. Understood? In segregated structure, all the gate, cathode, anode, all the three terminals are very close to each other. But here, some terminals are very far away from the anode, in the case of this method. So some of the areas becomes non-conducting immediately when anode current dips to zero. Some of the anode areas becomes non-conducting immediately. But that will not happen immediately in SCR. That will not happen immediately in SCR. But in GTO, immediately conducting areas becomes non-conducting. That will not happen with SCR because all the three terminals are very close to each other. Okay, so that is why you need not maintain continuous gate pulse in SCR, right now. In GTO, we have to maintain continuous gate pulse. In GTO, we have to maintain continuous gate pulse due to the following reason. The following reason. So write down the reason. Due to the power fluctuation, if anode current reduces to zero just for a moment, due to the power fluctuations, if anode current becomes zero just for a moment, Then some of the conducting areas becomes non-conducting. Then some of the conducting areas over the cathode periphery. If the anode current suddenly increases again, then the current density becomes very high. Then the current density becomes very high. because less conducting area is available, then the current density becomes very high. Then the current density becomes very high because less conduction area is available. Then the current density becomes very high because less conduction area is available. This results in local hotspots. This results in local hotspots and damage the device. This results in local hotspots and damage the device. Therefore, we must maintain continuous gate pulse. In bracket rate with reduced magnitude. And maintain the conducting areas. Okay. Yes. Now listen here. Now I want to turn off the GTO. To turn off the GTO, what we have to do? We have to provide a negative gate pulse. Here. To turn off the GTO, we have to provide a negative gate pulse. Turn off the GTO. So what is the negative gate pulse? You have to maintain. Negative gate pulse magnitude is 20 to 25% of this anode current. Okay. So what happens when I give negative gate pulse? See, when I give negative gate pulse to the GTO, this negative gate pulse is removing the charges which is already stored in the device. So when I apply negative gate pulse, the charges are removed during this region. That region we call it as storage time. During storage time, when I apply negative gate pulse, most of the charges are removed in the device. So here TS. TS means storage time. Most of the charges are removed in the device. Most of the charges are removed in the device. The anode current starts decreasing only after storage time when charges are removed. But during storage time, it will not reduce. Anode current will remain the same. So therefore, VAK will remain the same. See, when the anode current starts decreasing, after completion of storage time, when most of the charges are removed in the device, then anode current starts decreasing. Anode current starts decreasing at a faster rate at the beginning. Initially, this anode current starts decreasing at a faster rate. Then after some time, this Di/Dt will slow down. See, initially anode current is decreasing at a faster rate. After that, why it will slow down? See, this duration when anode current is decreasing at a faster rate, we call it as fall time. And the remaining time we call it as tail time. So total turn off time means storage time plus fall time plus dwell time. Second one is fall time. EF indicates fall time. Yes. Now see here. During this fall time, look here. During this fall time, di by dt is very fast. That means anode current decreases at a faster rate. Anode current will drop to zero immediately. That means di by dt is faster during fall time. Di by dt is faster during fall time. Di by dt is faster. Then during tail time, this is called tail time. During this tail time, di by dt is slow. During the tail time, di by dt is slow. During the tail time, the di by dt is slow. So during tail time, the di by dt is slow. Okay. So why di by dt is slow here during tail time? Why the di by dt will slow down here? See, I said during storage time, most of the charges are removed. So anode current drops immediately. When most of the charges are removed during storage time, anode current drops immediately. But after some time, the di by dt will slow down. I said most of the charges are removed, not all the charges. Some of the charges present in the n minus layer is still present. You know very well. The charges present in the lightly doped region takes more time to decompile. See, for heavily doped regions, the charges will recombine at a faster rate. But in the n minus layer, lightly doped region, it takes more time to recombine. So during storage time, charges are removed in all the layers, but in n minus layer, all the charges are not removed. Still, there are some more charges in the n minus layer yet to be removed. So during tail time, those charges present in the n minus layer is removed, because the lightly doped layer definitely requires more time for recombining electrons and holes. So during tail time, so why the di by dt will slow down? Because the minority charges present in the n minus layer takes more time to recombine. So that is why current is reducing at a slow rate. So during tail time, the charges present in the n minus layer are removed. So those charges present in the n minus layer takes more time to recombine. So that is why this current will slow down. Di by dt will slow down here. It will not reduce immediately. Right now, during n minus layer. Now wait a minute. During tail time, the charges present in the n minus layer is removed. During tail time, the charges present in the n minus layer is removed. Present in the n minus layer is removed. So what is the drawback with the tail time? Because of tail time, turnoff time will increase, and there is another problem also, I'll tell you later. And one more point is, this anode current suddenly drops. What happens when current suddenly decays? Generally, there will be inductance in the loop. See, when you are using the GTO, you are using some connecting wires. So for connecting wire, there is some loop inductance. What happens when there is loop inductance? So whenever there is inductance in the loop, if current suddenly drops to zero, what happens? If current suddenly drops to zero, high voltage will be induced across the device. Because you see, what is VL? LdI by dt. If current suddenly drops to zero, this is the current with respect to time. If current drops to zero within the zero time, what is the meaning? What is di by dt? Infinite. And di by dt infinite, what is the voltage? Infinite, no? But here it is not infinite. If current is dropping like this, it is infinite. But within less time, the current will drop to zero. So if current drops to zero within less time, then high voltage is induced across the device. So what happens to be high voltage? Very high voltage is induced across the device. So GTO may fail. So what we have to do? We have to use snubbers. I already said wherever there is a problem with during switching, use snubber and suppress the over voltage spike. Understood? So if I use snubber, we are suppressing the over voltage spike. If I am not using snubber, this over voltage spike will overshoot. Understood? This will overshoot. So GTO may fail. So this is with the snubber. After that, the voltage will increase and finally it will reach Vm. Understood? This is with the snubber. If I do not use snubber, this over voltage will reach very high voltage and GTO will fail. Understood? So note down there. Yes, tomorrow and Thursday and Friday your schedule 1 to 5 parallel runs. Thursday and Friday, that is tomorrow and day after tomorrow, your schedule is from 1 to 5 parallel runs, okay?
Hello.
Yes, series ki date badha di gayi hai 10 October tak hai. Aap agar abhi kisi ne nahi fill up kiya hai to aap log 10 October tak kar sakte ho aur 20 tarikh tak. इस 20 तक अभी जिन्होंने कूपन नहीं लिया वो 20 तारीख तक कूपन भी ले सकते हैं और फिलअप करने का टेस्ट है उसका लास्ट मंथ 10 अक्टूबर तक आप लोग फिलअप कर सकते हैं
Yes, see here. So what is the problem? Another problem here. Due to the sudden fall of anode current, see here. Due to the sudden fall of anode current, high voltage is induced across the GTO. Understood? So how to suppress that high voltage spike? So this is with the snubber. So snubber will suppress this over voltage. If I am not using the snubber, then high voltage is induced. So that may damage the device, right? So that is why snubber is very important during turn-off process for a GTO. So turn-off snubber will limit the over-voltage spike appearing across the GTO. So you can write on that point. Turn-off snubber is very important for a GTO. Turn-off snubber is very important for a GTO. To suppress the over voltage spike, Karnaugh snubber is very important for a GTO. Karnaugh snubber is very important for a GTO. Karnaugh snubber is very important for a GTO. To suppress the over voltage spike, Karnaugh snubber is very important for a GTO. To suppress the over voltage spike that appears across the device. That appears across the device during fault time. See, this is the fault time, right? See, I have given the waveform after using snubber. This is with snubber. Without snubber, this will be very high. So we cannot use the GTO. So this is with a snubber. Understood?
Fault time. Yeah. Device.
Then what is the another problem with tail time? See, during tail time, the power loss is significant. this voltage into this current. So power loss is significant during the tail time. So what are the problems with tail time? Tail time increases the turn off time and turn off power loss. So write down next point. Tail time increases the turn off time. Tail time increases the turn off time and turn off power loss. Tail time increases the turn off time and turn off power loss. So what is the only problem with G2 here? Tail time. If I can reduce the tail time, we don't have any problems. So how to reduce the tail time? So we have to cut the tail time now. How to reduce the tail time? We have to remodify the structure of G2. Again, we have to remodify the structure to reduce the tail time. So that remodified structure, we call it as anode shorted G2. Try the next point. To reduce the tail time, we have to use anode shorted G2O. To reduce the tail time, we have to use anode shorted GTO. Okay. Just slow down. See, everything is same. See, all the layers are same except the first layer only. First layer alternately P plus, N plus, P plus, N plus, P plus, N plus. Remaining layers N minus, P, N plus, that is same. Only the first layer will change. Yes. So this is called anode shorted G2O. Yes, now all of you listen here. What is this anode short? Look here. The problem, what is the main problem? Tail time. What is happening during tail time? Whatever charges are present in the N minus layer, those charges are removed. Those charges are removed through the P plus and anode. So it was taking more time. Now, if I put N plus layer here, those charges are directly removed through this. Because it is N plus layer is directly shorted with the anode through N plus. See, both the layers are N layers. Both are N layers means this is directly shorted with the anode. That means whatever charges are present in the N minus layer, those charges are immediately shorted with the anode. They are removed immediately. They need not pass through P plus and then. Those charges are directly shorted through the anode. See, this is another path. And this is another path. That means we are providing a short circuit for N minus for removing the charges immediately. That is called anode short. Anode short means the N minus layer is directly shorted with the anode through N plus. Now charges need not pass through P plus and anode. In the previous case, the charges should be removed through P plus layer. But now it is a direct shot. See. So tail time is almost eliminated now because of this reason. Because charges are removed immediately now. Through this shot. Because it is directly in touch with the anode. Through N plus layer. So charges are removed immediately. That is why we call it as anode shot. Anode shot and GTO. So that will eliminate the tail time. That will reduce the tail time. Tail time becomes very much lesser. It is almost eliminated, we can say. But always when we improve something, that will be disturbing something again. Is it not? I already said, when I want to improve something in the fabrication, that will be disturbing some parameters. If I can improve everything without disturbing something, then I'll get only one device now. What is the problem with this device? See, I will explain by using SCR so that you will be comfortable. You need not write down, okay? You will not do in SCR, okay? If I explain with SCR, you will be comfortable to understand. See, P plus, M minus, P and N plus. See, what happens when anode is positive with negative with respect to cathode? Which junctions are reverse biased? Anode minus cathode plus in SCR. J1 is reverse biased, J2 is forward biased, and J3 is reverse biased. So which junctions will block the reverse voltage? J1 and J3. Which junction will block more reverse voltage? Yes? J1. Suppose if I apply 5000 volts, J1 will block the entire reverse voltage. J3 blocks hardly 20 volts or 30 volts. J3 hardly blocks 20 volts or 30 volts. J1 blocks the entire reverse voltage, right? Suppose if I provide anode short for this. See, suppose if I do like this. P plus, N plus, again P plus. Now anode shorting is done. When there is anode short, there is no junction here. See, it is direct short. That means how can you get J1 now? When there is an anode short, you don't get J1 now. It is directly short. So that means now it cannot block the reverse voltage, it is direct short. Now how much reverse voltage it block? Only 10 volts or 20 volts. That means because of anode short, what is the problem? This GTO cannot block more reverse voltage. It will block very, very low reverse voltage. Some authors will say it is not blocking the reverse voltage. They will neglect this J3. They will say it is not blocking the reverse voltage. So always, when you gain something, you will be losing something. Is it not? So what is the problem with anode shorted GTO? This GTO cannot block the reverse voltage. Of course, it is not necessary in many applications. See, I want to use GTO in inverters and chopers. I don't require reverse blocking capability. In which applications I want reverse blocking mode? Rectifiers. In rectifiers, I want to block the reverse voltage. I want to block more reverse voltage, I want to block more forward voltage. And in rectifiers, I am not going to use the GTO. Suppose you want to use GTO in rectifiers, you need reverse blocking. You have to use the previous one. I hope you understood. So that is not needed in inverters and chopers. I don't require much reverse blocking capability in inverters and chopers. So that's not a problem at all, right? So write down. Anode shorted GTO reduce the turn-off time and turn-off power loss. Anode shorted GTO reduce the tail time. Anode shorted GTO reduce the tail time. Bracket, therefore turn on time reduces. Turn off time, not turn on. Anode shorted GTO reduce the tail time. Bracket, therefore turn off time reduces. And also reduce the turn off power loss. And also reduce the turn-off power loss. Okay. But this reduces the reverse blocking capability. But this reduces the reverse blocking capability to a very low value, to a very lesser value. But this reduces the reverse blocking capability to a very lesser value. So this reduces the reverse blocking capability to a very lesser value. Understood? Now I'll compare GTO with conventional thyristor. Conventional thyristor means normal SCR, okay? So write down next. Compare GTO compare GTO with a conventional thyristor. Compare GTO with a conventional thyristor. Compare GTO with a conventional thyristor. First point. The latching and holding current magnitudes is higher in GTO. The latching and holding current magnitudes is higher in GTO. The latching and holding current magnitudes is higher in GTO. Then next, second point, the on-state voltage drop is higher in GTO. Second point, the on-state voltage drop is higher in GTO. The on-state voltage drop is higher in GTO. The on-state voltage drop is higher in GTO. The next, third point. GTO has fast turn-on and turn-off times. GTO has fast turn-on and turn-off times. GTO has fast turn-on and turn-off times, and therefore operates with higher switching frequency. GTO has fast turn-on and turn-off times. GTO has fast turn-on and turn-off times, and therefore operates with higher switching frequency. Okay. The next point. The gate signal requirement is higher in GTO. The gate signal requirement is higher in GTO. The next, all of look here. Suppose if I say SCR unit, what is the meaning of SCR unit? SCR, it's firing circuit, commutation circuit, production circuit. So all the circuits if you add, that unit is GTO, SCR unit. If I compare SCR unit and GTO unit, for GTO unit you don't have commutation circuit. So GTO unit is more efficient and compact in size when you compare with the SCR unit. Next point. GTO unit is more efficient and compact in size when compared with the SCR unit. Next point. GTO has low turn on gain and low turn off gain. What is the meaning of turn on gain? First you write on that point. GTO has low turn on gain and low turn off gain. So what is turn on gain? Turn on gain is the ratio of anode current and gate signal, positive gate pulse. See, GTO gate pulse is higher now. When you compare with SCR, gate pulse is higher. So turn on gain will reduce. Similarly, what is turn off gain? Turn off gain again is the ratio of maximum anode current and the negative gate pulse. See, IGN is the negative gate pulse magnitude. So here this is also higher. So turn off gain is also lesser. So that is the drawback here. So GTO, that is the disadvantage, okay? So GTO is having lesser turn on gain and lesser turn off gain. What is the application? Where we are using this one? Write down application. CTO can be used in inverters and troppers. CTO can be used in inverters and troppers by replacing the thyristor. GTO can be used in GTO can be used in inverters and choppers by replacing the thyristor, so that we need not use commutation circuit. Okay. So that's about GTO. The next special device is ASCR. What is this ASCR? Asymmetrical silicon control rectifier. Next, ASCR. What is the difference between symmetrical SCR and asymmetrical SCR? See, for symmetrical SCR, the forward locking and reverse locking capability are almost equal. For a symmetrical SCR, you see, suppose if it is blocking 5000 volts, it will also block minus 5000 volts. It is blocking 4000 volts, it is also blocking minus 4000 volts. That is symmetrical SCR. But asymmetrical means forward characters are same. Asymmetrical SCR blocks 5000 volts. We are having forward blocking, forward connection. What about reverse blocking? In asymmetrical SCR, the reverse blocking capability is reduced. Generally, it is in volts. Asymmetrical SCR blocks a reverse voltage up to 30 volts or 20 volts. It blocks very low reverse voltage. It blocks 5000 volts. See, forward, there is nothing difference in the forward characters. Same as normal SCR. See, there is nothing difference here. There is nothing difference. Everything is same. Then what makes the difference? So that means in asymmetrical SCR, we are reducing this quality. Right? We are reducing this quality. Why we have to reduce? Because in all applications, we don't require high reverse blocking capability. See, in some of the applications, you want high reverse blocking capability, you can use SCR. But some applications, we don't require high reverse blocking capability. When you don't require high reverse blocking capability, you can reduce that quality. Why you are reducing? Because we can gain something. Otherwise, why you lose? I am losing means to gain some parameters. I don't want this parameter here. See, in some of the applications, I don't want high reverse blocking capability. I don't want high reverse blocking capability in some of the applications. I tell you application also. When I don't require high reverse blocking capability, better reduce this one to improve something. You know very well, in the fabrication, if I want to improve something, if I want to improve EBR, we lost something, no? If I want to improve this one, we lost something. When I don't want this one, why should I lose that something? So reduce this one. So that is the concept in this case. Just now I said in anode shorted GTO also. If I don't require high level clocking capability here also, anode short. So you can reduce the turnoff time, switching frequency. See, voltage source inverter, across each thyristor there is an anti-parallel diode. Across each thyristor there is an anti-parallel diode in voltage source inverter. See, two anti-parallel devices cannot connect at a time, you know very well. When SCR is in the off state, this diode is in the on state. So who is applying reverse voltage across the SCR? The drop-off diode. See, in this application, the drop-off diode is applying reverse voltage across the SCR. So what is the maximum drop-off diode? It cannot be more than 3 volts. That means what is the reverse voltage applied across the SCR? 3 volts. Then why should I use the SCR which blocks 5000 volts? When it is not needed. It's not needed, no? In this application, the drop-off diode is maximum 3 volts. So the reverse voltage applied across the SCR is 3 volts. Then why should I use the thyristor which blocks the reverse voltage of 5000? That means I am not using that quality. When I am not using that one, better reduce that one so that you can gain something. So that is ACR. So ACR is a special thyristor with reduced reverse blocking capability. Right on that point. ACR is a special thyristor. So ACR is a special thyristor with reduced reverse blocking capability. ACR is a special thyristor with reduced reverse blocking capability. ACR is a special thyristor with reduced reverse blocking capability. With reduced reverse blocking capability. Okay. Next point. Why we are reducing that quality? Because it is not needed in some applications. Because it is not needed in some applications, I am reducing that one so that I can gain some other parameters. Okay. Next point. ACR has fast turn on and turn off times. ACR has fast turn on and turn off times. ACR has fast turn on and turn off times. Therefore, it operates with higher switching frequency. ACR has fast turn on and turn off times. ACR has fast turn on and turn off times. Therefore, it operates with higher switching frequency. Therefore, it operates with higher switching frequency when compared with the thyristor or SCR. Therefore, it operates with higher switching frequency when compared with the SCR. Therefore, it operates with higher switching frequency when compared with the SCR. Okay. So now see here. What happens if I use two devices? That means, what is the application here? In the case of voltage source inverter, instead of using normal SCR, we can replace this one by ACR. I can replace this one by ACR. Symbol is same. SCR and ACR same symbol. So instead of using normal SCR, better replace that by ACR. Write on the application. ACR can be used in voltage source inverter. ACR can be used in voltage source inverter. ACR can be used in voltage source inverter. ACR can be used in voltage source inverter by replacing the normal SCR. By replacing the normal SCR. By replacing the normal SCR. Okay. Now see here. Now another question is, when I use two devices, I have to use two heat sinks, and it will occupy more space and weight. Understood? Now the question is, can't you develop a single device which replaces these two devices? Can't you develop a single device which replaces these two devices, so that it is very compact, one heat sink is sufficient, That is called RCP. RCP, reverse conducting transistor. So why we are developing the device? We are developing RCT to replace this set. In PSI, I have to use ACR and separate diode and connect them to heat sinks. That will occupy more space and weight, is it not? So better develop one more device which replaces this set. That is RCT. Right now, next device is RCT. So instead of using normal ACR, better replace that by ACR. So write down the application. ACR can be used in voltage source inverter. ACR can be used in voltage source inverter. ACR can be used in voltage source inverter. ACR can be used in voltage source inverter by replacing the normal ACR. Okay. Now see here. Now another question is, when I use two devices, I have to use two heat sinks, and it will occupy more space and weight. Understood? Now the question is, can't you develop a single device which replaces these two devices? So that it is very compact, one heat sink is sufficient. That is called RCP. RCP, reverse conducting transistor. So why we are developing the device? We are developing RCT to replace this set. In PSI, I have to use ACR and separate diode and connect them to heat sinks. That will occupy more space and weight, is it not? So better develop one more device which replaces this set. That is RCT. Right now, next device is RCT. RCT means reverse conducting transistor. So what is this reverse conducting transistor? How many devices we are having in RCT? RCT is one device, don't say two. It's one unit. See, this is RCT. Don't see this one as two devices. It is one device. Understood? So in RCT, there is an inbuilt diode. This is an inbuilt structure. We are not separately connecting. Within the same structure of transistor, we are having an inbuilt anti-parallel diode. It is an inbuilt. Anti-parallel diode is inbuilt within the same unit. Right on. In RCT, an anti-parallel diode is inbuilt. An anti-parallel diode is inbuilt across the SCR. An anti-parallel diode is inbuilt across the SCR within the same structure. In RCT, an anti-parallel diode is inbuilt across the SCR within the same structure. Okay, so RCT is one unit. Understood? The equivalent of RCT is thyristor and anti-parallel diode. This is the equivalent of RCT. Understood? But it is only one unit. Now draw the VA characters of RCT. Look here. RCT means reverse conducting thyristor. What happens when anode is positive with respect to cathode? If I do not give gate pulse, RCT blocks the forward voltage. If I do not give the gate pulse, RCT block the forward voltage. When I give gate pulse to the RCT, then RCT starts connecting to the forward direction. So forward connection, this is the forward connection. Forward connection. Same forward connection. Forward connection. This is because of this device. Then what happens when I make anode negative with respect to cathode? Yes? Diode connects. That means reverse connection. Show me the reverse connection. This is forward connection. This is forward connection. Show me reverse connection. Exactly symmetrically negative. Forward connection means reverse connection, right? So, reverse connection. See, it's called RCT. Reverse connection. Let's do it. So you will get forward blocking, forward connection, reverse connection. What is the mistake you will do? See here, you will say, this is forward connection for diode. Why you are seeing it as diode? See it as a one unit. In this unit, this is forward connection, means this is reverse connection. That's the way you have to understand. Some student will come and ask me, forward connection of what diode? Why you are seeing it as a diode? See it as RCT. It's not diode. See it as RCT. That's why I put it. This is forward means this is reverse connection. Okay. See. So RCT can block the reverse voltage now? It can block the reverse voltage? No. RCT cannot block reverse voltage now, right? See. That means if you take ideal case, see this is practical. Ideal. This is practical means ideal. This is practical means ideal. See, forward connection, reverse connection. Forward blocking. So for SCR and ACR, forward blocking, forward connection, reverse blocking. For SCR and ACR. RCT cannot block reverse voltage. It is bidirectional. RCT is bidirectional device. Bidirectional means here. It is bidirectional for current, not for voltage. It is bidirectional for current. Is it bidirectional for voltage? It can block bidirectional voltage. No, it can block only forward voltage. It cannot block negative voltage right now. RCT cannot block the reverse voltage. RCT cannot block the reverse voltage. RCT cannot block the reverse voltage. It is bidirectional for current but not for voltage. It is bidirectional for current. It is bidirectional for current but not for voltage. It is bidirectional for current. It is bidirectional for current but not for voltage. So in which application I can use RCT? Same in VSI. In VSI, using SCR, another anti-parallel diode, using two heat sinks, making it complicated, better replace that one by a single device known as RCT. Okay, so that will be more compact because we are using only one heat sink for both the devices. Right now, in voltage source inverters, we can replace thyristor and anti-parallel diode. In voltage source inverters, we can replace thyristor and anti-parallel diode by using an RCT. In voltage source inverters, we can replace thyristor and anti-parallel diode by using an RCT. Okay. Now see here, what is the equivalent of RCT? What is the equivalent of RCT? Thyristor and anti-parallel diode. Don't call it as two devices, it is only one device. Its equivalent is two devices. Its equivalent is thyristor and anti-parallel diode. Then what is the equivalent of track? Two anti-parallel thyristors. That is the equivalent of track. So for track, see, RCT is bidirectional for current, but not for voltage. What about track? It is bidirectional for current as well as bidirectional for voltage. I hope you understood. Already in the introduction class, I gave you information. It is acting as an AC switch, mainly used in AC voltage controllers, AC to AC converters. So I know, track. So see here, the terminals of this track is, we call it as main terminal 1 and main terminal 2. See, we will not call it as anode and cathode what we are showing in SCR. Why? Both the terminals are symmetrical. Even if I reverse the track, nothing will happen. I can use track in any direction. So that's why we are not calling it as anode and cathode. But when I draw the VA characters, I will write VAK. I don't want to write VMT1, MT2. Understood? So that is why I am marking as anode cathode. Just to draw VAK to show anode current. Okay? So the equivalent of RCD is two thyristors connected in anti-parallel. So you can note this one. It's the equivalent of a track. So again, don't call it as two anti-parallel thyristors. There are two devices. The equivalent of track is two anti-parallel devices. Already you know the VA characters for track. When you will get this one, forward clocking, forward connection means if main terminal 1 is positive with respect to main terminal 2, what happens? If I do not give gate pulse, it will drop the forward voltage. At present we are having SCR which can block up to 5000 volts. But at present we are having trier which can only block 1000 volts or less than that. Trier cannot block 5000 volts, we don't have. At present we are having trier which blocks 1000 volts or less than that. We don't have trier at high voltage. Like I see here, right? Blocking capability is reduced in trier. See, without gate pulse, again, see here, same strategy. Remaining strategy is same. Without gate pulse, breakdown occurs at VBO. As I increase the gate pulse, here we have to give positive gate pulse. As I increase the gate pulse, what happens? The breakdown voltage will decrease, VB1, see. When I increase the gate pulse, breakdown voltage will decrease. If I further increase the gate pulse, it is IG2 more than IG1. This is the new breakdown voltage. So this strategy already I said in SCR also. Then you will get symmetrical characters because of anti-parallel thyristor. You will get exactly symmetrical characters in the third quadrant also. When main terminal 1 is negative with respect to main terminal 2. When main terminal 1 is negative with respect to main terminal 2. Here we have to provide negative gate pulse. VBR, this is kilovolts. We don't have 1000 volts. Are less than that. Reverse blocking, reverse connection. So here negative gate pulse is 0. See, without gate pulse, breakdown occurs at VBR. So here, to turn on the track in the forward direction, give positive gate pulse. To turn on the track in the negative direction, when MT1 is negative with respect to MT2, then we have to give negative gate pulse. So same strategy here also. Minus IG1. Then again, minus IG2, see same strategy here. As I increase the negative gate pulse, reverse breakdown decreases. As I increase the positive gate pulse, forward breakdown decreases. That's more than this. Okay. So track will support all the four modes of operation, therefore it is treated as AC switch. So that is used in AC voltage controller. Can you tell me the applications? It is used in fan regulators, temperature controllers, fan regulators. Okay. Then temperature controller, etc. Fan regulators, temperature controllers, etc. Okay. But there is limitation for a track. What is the limitation? Track is used only for low and medium power applications. Suppose you want high power applications, I cannot use track. In that case, we have to use two anti-parallel thyristors. In AC voltage controllers, if you cannot use a track due to the limitations, in that case you can use two anti-parallel thyristors. What is the limitation of track? It is used only for low and medium power applications. So write down the limitations. Limitation of a trial, first point. Limitation of a trial, first point. It is used only for low and medium power applications. It is used only for low and medium power applications. It is used only for low and medium power applications. Low and medium power applications. It is used only for low and medium power applications. Second point. See here, in AC voltage controllers, track is used only with resistive load and inductive load with lesser time constant. It is not used for high inductive load where the time constant is high. Okay, I will explain that one, why it is not used for inductive loads when the time constant is high. You will understand when I draw the waveforms in AC voltage controllers. See, I will draw the waveforms in AC voltage controllers with inductive loads. There you will understand the reason. Okay, for time being, you note that, note down that point. Second point, in AC voltage controllers, In AC voltage controllers, track is used only with resistive load and inductive load with lesser time constant, and inductive load with lesser time constant. In AC voltage controllers, track is used only with resistive load and inductive load with lesser time constant. It is not used with high inductive load when the time constant is high. It is not used with high inductive load when the time constant is higher. Okay. So these are the limitations of track. See, track is a controlled AC switch, right? Track is a controlled AC switch. We are also having uncontrolled AC switch. That uncontrolled AC switch is called as tire. What is the difference between track and tire? We don't have a control terminal. We don't have a control terminal. This is an uncontrolled switch. Can you tell me what is the equivalent of tire? Two anti-parallel diodes. Don't write that wrong. What is the meaning of two anti-parallel diodes? Forward connection, reverse connection. Short circuit. Short circuit means connecting wire. That means instead of purchasing a connecting wire, you will purchase two anti-parallel diodes. Connect them again, connecting wires. Why you connect like this? You cannot block the forward voltage. You cannot block the reverse voltage. Very casual answer. If you think, you will not say the answer. Because I removed the gate valves here, you removed the gate valves there. So we will never connect in anti-parallel diodes. You are connecting anti-parallel diode means you are stupid. Why you will connect anti-parallel diodes? That means a connecting wire. Anti-parallel diode means short circuit. That means a connecting wire. So we will not do this, right? Then you may ask the question. When I am having controlled AC switch, what is the need of uncontrolled AC switch? There should be some application, no? Without application, why they will introduce this device? Some application should be there, see. What is the only difference here? We don't have gate signal. Then how it will trigger? How the diode will trigger here? I don't have any gate pulse. Then how the diode will trigger in this case? I don't have gate pulse. If we increase the forward voltage, when it reaches VPO, then it will trigger. Understood? If we increase the reverse voltage, when it reaches VPR, then it will trigger in the negative direction. Now tell me, what is the use of this diode? When I am already having a controlled AC switch, where should I use uncontrolled AC switch, you say? When I am having a controlled AC switch, where should I use this one, say? How it will turn on? As you increase the forward voltage, when it reaches VPO, at that instant, it will turn on now. That means when VAK reaches VPO, the diode changes from blocking mode to conduction mode. Blocking mode to conduction mode. Similarly, if I increase the reverse voltage, when it reaches VPR, then it will change from reverse blocking to reverse conduction. That means we can change the status of the switch only when I apply a reverse voltage or forward voltage up to its breakdown voltage level. We don't have gate pulse. Why should I use this uncontrolled switch? When I am already having controlled switch, why should I use uncontrolled switch? Why it is developed? There should be some application. Yes, there is an application. We are using a diode where you cannot use a trial. I give you a hint, you try. We are using a diode where we cannot use a trial. Yes. You see the limitations and say the answer. That's what I say. You see the limitations wherever you cannot use that. That's not the correct strategy. Track is used in track firing circuit. That is developed only for that purpose. In track firing circuit, I cannot use another track. For the track, another firing circuit. So, diode is used in track firing circuit. So, very important application. That is the only reason it was developed. So, that is the point. Diode is used in track firing circuit. Diode is used in track firing circuit. Diode is used in track firing circuit. Okay. So now I'll explain. So this question was asked in IES conversion paper. Track firing circuit using a diode. Track firing circuit. See, when I was explaining firing circuit of SCR, what did I say? For R firing, we have taken half wave rectifier. For RC, we have taken full wave rectifier. See, if you want to explain a firing circuit, we have to take one example for a power circuit, right? So, what type of power circuit you want to consider for track? Yes? What type of power circuit you want to consider? Half wave or full wave? उनमें वाई ओर यूज इडेंटिफाई करना वाई ओर यूज ट्रैक इडेंटिफाई जस्ट नाउ व्हाट इट इज एस यू स्विच एस यू वोल्टेज कंट्रोलर सो वेयर इट इज यूज एस यू वोल्टेज कंट्रोलर एंड एज फुल वेव और हाफ वेव फुल वेव यू आर सेइंग यू आर नॉट यूजिंग बोथ डायरेक्ट बस सो व्हाट द पावर सर्किट वी हैव टू कंसीडर AC voltage controller. So here the main circuit is the main circuit is single phase AC voltage controller. What is this one? What is this circuit? It is a half wave rectifier, not AC voltage regulator. Why? Because it is a DC switch. It is a half wave rectifier. If I remove this DC switch and put an AC switch like that, then it is nothing but AC voltage controller. Now it is AC voltage controller. Let the load resistance be RL. Okay. So this is the power circuit here. Now let me use RC firing circuit. See, this is the power circuit. Now I am using RC firing circuit here. See, in this case, the forward clocking and reverse clocking capabilities of dial should not be more than the peak value of supply. It should be less than the peak value. So now see, it's a positive cycle. This is positive, this is negative, right? Initially, I did not give gate pulse to the track. When I am not giving gate pulse to the track, what happens? Track remains in the off state. That means forward clocking mode. When track remains in the off state, then the supply is charging the capacitor. When supply is charging the capacitor, then capacitor voltage will increase exponentially. Here, now let me draw the VC waveform. So initially track is in the off state. Capacitor voltage will increase and track is in the off state, capacitor is charging. Okay. So what is the first mode here? Forward clocking state. So track remains in the off state, that is why the capacitor is charging. When it reaches VP over, what happens? At this instant, when it reaches this is alpha. When it reaches VBO, what happens? VBO means forward breakdown. So forward breakdown occurs for the dial. After forward breakdown, the capacitor starts discharging the positive gate pulse. See, this capacitor will start discharging the positive gate pulse now. It is discharging the positive gate pulse. So after that, track starts conducting in the forward direction. So that means after this point, second mode, you will get forward conduction mode. Okay. So capacity is discharging here. Capacity is discharging. What is the discharging time constant? It is very small, huh? See here. The capacitor discharging time constant is very small. So that will discharge within lesser time. What is the first mode? The first mode, when I am not giving gate pulse, it remains in the blocking mode. So the supply will charge the capacitor. So capacitor voltage is increasing. When the capacitor voltage reaches VBO, at this instant, when it reaches VBO, forward breakdown occurs. After breakdown, the capacitor starts discharging. When it is discharging, it is supplying the first to get pulse. When it is supplying the first to get pulse, then it starts conducting. So track starts conducting in the forward direction. That is the second mode. That means in the positive cycle we are getting forward blocking, forward conduction. In the same way, negative cycle reverse blocking, reverse conduction. In the negative cycle, supply polarities will reverse, right? See here. What happens in the negative cycle? Supply polarities will reverse now. What happens when supply polarities reverses? See here. When supply polarities reverses, now MT1 is minus, MT2 is plus. That means track is blocking the reverse voltage. See here. Track is blocking the reverse voltage now. When track is blocking the reverse voltage, so now what happens? When it is blocking the reverse voltage, what happens? The supply is charging the capacitor. Now what is the actual polarities? Plus or minus? So capacitor is positively charged or negatively charged? According to this reference, capacitance is negatively charged. So in the negative cycle, this capacitance is negatively charged at this instant. So that is pi plus alpha, at pi plus alpha. So that is the third mode. We call it as reverse blocking mode. So what happens when it reaches VBR? When it reaches VBR, see here, when this voltage reaches VBR, reverse breakdown occurs for diode. After reverse breakdown, it will discharge the negative gate pulse or positive gate pulse. This is opposite to the reference now. So when it is discharging the negative gate pulse, then track conducts in the negative direction. See, track will conduct in the negative direction, reverse conduction. Okay, so the fourth mode is the reverse conduction mode. Reverse conduction mode. So this capacitor will discharge immediately. This capacitor will discharge in the negative direction immediately. Immediately it will discharge. So for one cycle of AC source voltage, the track is supporting all the four modes. How many modes we require in AC voltage controller?
Four
modes. That's what we are getting here. See, this is our supply waveform. See here. This is our supply waveform, right? How you are controlling the voltage? How you are controlling the RMS voltage? I already said in the introduction class, no? Block the forward voltage for some time. Block the reverse voltage for some time. So forward blocking, forward conduction, reverse blocking, reverse conduction. Now this is the output voltage. By changing alpha, area changes. That's what I said. How to change alpha? Why we are using variable resistor? To change alpha. This one I already explained in the introduction class only. By changing alpha, area changes. So area changes means RMS value will change. See here, make sure that the load resistance is very much lesser when you compare with R. Generally R is